In the last video, we saw how we can connect Foundry with our data sources, which in our example include a Postgres database, an Azure Blob Store, as well as a REST API, among others. With our data now synced to Foundry, we can start transforming it. If we click on any dataset in our data lineage view of our pipeline, we can see the code that was used to apply this transformation by clicking on Code on the bottom panel. What we see is the PySpark code that was used to create the dataset. Under the hood, Foundry leverages a Spark on Kubernetes implementation as the compute engine for batch computation, and Flink on Kubernetes for streaming purposes, providing a flexible compute foundation that can be tailored to your use cases. The platform generally supports any languages that have Spark bindings, as we run Foundry's compute engine using Spark on Kubernetes. In addition to the actual transformation logic, which is captured here, there are a few additional decorators that help you natively interact with your Foundry environment. For example, the transform decorator allows you to specify the input and output datasets, abstracting away the underlying data cataloging system that ensures you're always running on the freshest data. Similarly, the configure decorator allows you to configure the Spark environment on which a given transform will run, since you'll sometimes need to tweak the environment to handle larger workloads. To see how you're able to author all this code, let's click on View and Repository, which takes us to Foundry's Code Repositories tool, an integrated development environment that allows you to build robust, validated data pipelines. To the left, we've got a dynamic sidebar that updates to the view that you choose, for instance, displaying your file structure, repository-wide searching, and a package management UI. In the main part of the application, we have a code editor that comes complete with linting and code assist. This IDE comes fully backed by a highly available Git service to enable you to commit, version, and collaborate in your data pipelines. This idea of versioning doesn't just end with the code that you write. Foundry also versions the data itself. So when you go to create a branch off the production code like I've just done to implement some changes to the pipeline, Foundry automatically creates a branch for that data too. You're now able to branch an entire pipeline from production into a development branch, make changes, and validate your modifications. This is one of Foundry's key strengths. Data branching removes the traditional trade-off between speed of iteration and the stability of your pipelines. With data branching, you can move as fast as you need to build value in your business, but without the risk that usually comes with normal staging to production promotion paradigms. Best of all, Foundry takes care of all the underlying coordination for you. Again, all in the singular pursuit of maximizing your focus on building out value using your data. Let's make some of our changes here and commit them. Once we're happy with the modifications, we can merge our changes back into the master branch with a pull request process, just as you would in a traditional software engineering scenario, by clicking Propose Changes, and we'll go ahead and give a title and description to our PR. In the PR creation wizard, you can give your PR a title and description, as well as add the relevant approvers to review changes. While the pull request process is largely similar to what you might have faced in a regular software engineering scenario, reviewing changes to data pipelines requires additional tools to really help the approver make sense of the proposed changes. Foundry makes it incredibly intuitive to understand the impact of the changes by showing you the diff and the code files, not unlike what you may have seen when merging code to another branch before, an impact analysis of the modifications, which helps you understand the downstream effects of your modifications on the overall pipeline, an overall pipeline review, which provides a graphical representation of the pipeline highlighting datasets that have been changed, a conversation tracker where you can keep track of comments. Once everything looks good, your reviewers can approve and merge the PR, which will merge your modifications back into the production pipeline. Code Repositories makes pipeline building as seamless as possible, allowing you to focus your efforts on building your data assets by abstracting away all the overhead required to maintain these pipelines. In the next video, we'll take a look at some of the other functionality available in Foundry to complement your data integration.